Hey yo, what's up? Hody Ian here, and today I am gonna recommend you which banda you should buy in the Black Friday sale. First of all, I think Digital Legends actually cheated my money, because when I go onto my Samsung S3, they didn't even discount the price of the bundles. Look. It shows here Singapore dollars $9.98. Okay, wow. I still have a bit of internet, but anyways, I bought these for actually $14.98. It showed here only $9. So basically, Digital Legends cheated my money, but the retard, so I can't do anything about it. Anyway, let's say you have only $20 left and you can buy one bundle. You don't know which bundle you should buy. Let me recommend you one bundle. First of all, we are gonna talk about the pros and cons about these, all of these bundles. First of all, let's talk about the Hulk equipment. Contains the Battle Hulk, the armor, 7% accuracy, 15% health, and 17% agility. The Battle Ram, one of the most overpowered weapons in this game. First of all, let me tell you, don't buy this bundle. First of all, these Battle Ram is overpowered. We don't want noobs coming into our community, and Battle Ram users just really spoils the fun. It just suck. So don't buy this bundle. Never do it. Okay, so second, the Protector's Kit. The ASP armor is still okay. It actually reduces the damage we see from energy weapons by 70%. That means, the plasma punch, the zap gun, and I think including the plasma shotgun, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, this is also an energy weapon, I guess. And also the the Ghostbusters, what do you call that? Let's check it. This weapon, the proton gun, I think it reduces 70% damage as well. So yeah, pretty cool. This is one of the most underrated weapons in Respawnables. People think, hey, the shockwave launcher sucks because it has no splash damage. Now, if you use it, you realize that this is almost like a two-shot flare gun. So I don't think it is actually bad. Let's say if you're standing, on the ground, you're not camping, and you have to shoot the person and not the floor. This is not the tamper, howitzer. This is like a flare gun. So you shoot at a person, and if it hits the person, it will be a two-shot kill if your shots are very accurate. Some people would say it sucks, but when I use it, it's really, really good. When you are camping, this weapon is really, really good. You can just aim at a person's head or something. And very, very good. Very, very good bundle. Next is the Cyber Ninja Gear. The reason why I wanted to buy this bundle is because of this. Spot enemies and identify their rank when standing still. The identify the rank, let's say if you're just a newbie to this game. During December, there was this event called the Cyber Ninja event. And then it kind of sucks. The event really sucks. But there will be ranks, and if you have a 3-star rank, that's the maximum, and you will receive additional points to help you progress through the next tier. So anyways, the number of points you get also shows the number of, the type of rank you are in. To get these points, you must you must kill enemies, and yeah, when you have a rank, then yeah, if you have a 3-star rank, your total points will be double and all this blah blah. Okay, the Cyber Ninja breastplate is pretty overpowered. Look, because it's someone going invisible the whole match, even if you don't, even if you shoot a person and he receives damage and all this, he's still invisible. Anyway, the next one is the, Cyber Ninja Greaves. 25% reduction on your gadget cooldown. It's still pretty cool. If you couldn't, let's say if you want to afford some spotters and all this, and then sometimes you don't have the spotters cooldown to cool down fully yet, so you can't activate your spotter. I don't know if I phrased that correctly, probably no, but yeah, cooldown, yeah, that's pretty cool, because actually there is a power up when you reach level 4. Yeah, right over here beside the gun icon, there's this thing. Now, there's one part when they say, reduce, I think 25% or 20%, I forgot, or maybe 30%. You need gold to afford it. If you don't have enough gold, then this will be perfect. The dual energy pistols, is pretty good. It's pretty good. Maybe I guess it's a bit underrated. Hardly anyone uses this weapon, but yeah, it is very good. I don't know what's with all this anthem drone sign, pretty weird, but yeah. Next we have is the Brazilian Warrior Courier. The only good thing about this is the dual key machine guns. Now don't use all this shit, reduce 60% of the damage caused by the dual revolvers. Especially these, everyone is pissed off with. Provides extra protection by reducing 60% of damage caused by the revolver. Overpowered. Why? Because revolver is one of the most balanced weapons in the Spartabus. For some of you newbies who don't know what revolver is, this is the revolver. This one. Level 26. Really, very balanced, very, very good to use. I like it. But anyway, yeah, let's get back. So, yeah, Blunderbuss is already pretty much dead. There's also the close quarter pants that actually nerfed the Blunderbuss by 60% as well. Digital Legends really made a really wrong choice to go out to this step. Pay to win, seriously. But it's really good. The dual commotion guns is really good. So if you didn't manage to complete the event, this is the right choice. You get the dual commotion guns through the close quarters event. I don't know how you say it. The summer camp, yeah, summer camp. The close quarters. Anyways, yeah. This is also very good to nerf Whiplash, because we want to get gold from him. And yeah, that's the only advantage of this. Next is the Warrior Bunny Kit. Nothing good about this bundle except Hunter Rifle. Good sniper, sometimes a one shot kill, but mostly a two shot kill if you meet elites and all these. Warrior Bunny Mask, spot and track Easter eggs drop around the scenery. Distinguish between single and triple eggs. Yeah, pretty good. This is effective in the Easter event. So yeah, Hunter Rifle, all this So you did all the bandas. Five bandas. Yeah, after talking so much, let's just get straight to the point. What banda would I recommend you to choose? This is really out. This is pretty good. This is still okay. Almost useless. It's still pretty good. Now let me show you the top three bandas I will recommend. This is out. Warrior Bunny Kids, The Protectors Kids, and Cyber Ninja Gear. That's the top three bundles I will recommend. And the top bundle, it's very hard to choose. Let's see. If you are actually good in sniper, you should get a hunter rifle. It takes skill. But yeah. Anyway, this is my final decision. I will choose this. The Warrior Bunny Kids. It is really, really good. But if you suck at sniper, then this. You can spot enemies pretty good. Just do, yeah. And if this, use this to go with sniper, it is just awesome because when you camp, and you know, you can spot enemies and use a hunter rifle or semi-automatic sniper or the noob sniper. And yeah, then screw that up, but yeah, never mind. But you know, my final decision, if you are actually not really elite yet, get this bundle. So this is the final bundle I will recommend you to get. Well, don't really use this because it's pretty overpowered. You can use this camp with your whole howitzer, and you know, it's very good because if you want to get 40 kills in a match, the best gadget to use is, you know, using the spotter. If you don't know what that is, it's right over here. That's right. Anyway, yeah, that's all for me. Yeah, that's all for me, and I hope to see you guys in the next one. Final bundle I would recommend: stand still, spot enemies, snipe them down, or maybe stand still, spot enemies, and shoot them with your revolver or howitzer, whatever. Yeah, final bundle I would recommend is this, but don't forget this. Shotgun launcher is really good. But anyways, hope you enjoy, and goodbye.